What's up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I have a long-awaited coat collection video for you guys. As you guys know, I have tons of them, so I figured I would do this little roundup and show you guys what I wear for the fall and winter season. I am leaving out my lighter coats, my more transitional pieces, because I do want to do a spring one, so that will include like my Burberry trenches and leather jackets. So this one is mostly like long wool coats, and then I have a couple of shorter ones as well, but that is today's video. So we are going to just dive right in. But if you're new here and you enjoy these kinds of videos, as well as luxury fashion, vlogs, interiors, home stuff, please hit the subscribe button as well as the notifications bell so that you know when I post new videos. And feel free to check me out on Instagram where I post every single day and you can see all these coats styled. It is starting to get a lot colder, so I will be keeping more of these in rotation. As for the format of this video, I don't want to ramble on too much about each piece because there's a ton of them. I don't even know how many coats there are. I'll try and do a little description about each piece, but the names and the brand and the size will be written out in text because I don't know if I can remember them off the top of my head, but I'll try and give you guys a little spiel about each piece without rambling on too much. But that's about it, so let's get to the video. So the first coat is this aviator style teddy coat from Aritzia that I love so much. It's at a cropped length, so it's really cute when you pair it with jeans or chunky boots. This is just a great kind of transitional piece when it starts to get cold, but it's not too cold, but it's really soft, really cozy, and this is a great little sporty casual look. This next one is one of my favorites, and it is from Gani. I got it from Shopbop a little while ago when I was working with them. I just think it is the perfect kind of buffalo print plaid coat. It is absolutely beautiful and just drapes so nicely. This is definitely great when I want to make a little bit more of a statement. It's a print that can grab attention, and it's still subtle and, you know, kind of monochrome and muted enough for it to not be that loud, but I absolutely love this coat. It is one of my favorites. I don't know if they still have it. This is definitely one that really stands out in my collection when I have it lined up in the closet. So I do love to rock this with an all black look. I think it's just so chic and definitely keeping this in my wardrobe for a really long time. Next coat is a recent addition. This is the S-Max Mara coat that I got from Farfetch. It's a pretty thin material, although it can still keep you warm. I wouldn't wear this too deep into winter, but it is a very pretty kind of overcoat to wear with a more formal setting. This has a tie around it to kind of cinch the waist because it doesn't have buttons, but I will say that I do wish that it had loops on the coat so that that tie could drape and hang rather than just tying it in order to secure it. So if I wanted to wear this coat open, I couldn't keep that tie with me. I could probably lose it if I did, but nevertheless, it's still a really beautiful and elegant coat. Don't have any actual Max Mara coats in my collection, although maybe one day that is kind of on my bucket list. I just don't know which style I'm into. So this next coat is another one of my, well, okay, I'm gonna end up saying that every single coat here is my favorite, but this is my Sandro coat, and the collar is really cool because it kind of has this scarf feature to it, and it's just really nice to kind of hang over and drape. And this coat really looks great open as well, even if I didn't want to throw the scarf over my shoulders. It adds a little bit of a fringe element to it, but this is just a really sleek and chic coat and definitely perfect for the city when I don't want to wear one of my chunkier ones. So you guys will see that I'm really into these kinds of coats because it's honestly what I feel the most confident in when I am getting dressed and in the city. So definitely love this Sandro one. This one is from Anina Bing, and it is a navy coat. I believe it's called the Dylan, and this just drapes really, really nicely. So I actually got this coat because I fell in love with a Loewe coat, I think a year or two ago, but it was just not in my price range. I was hung up on a navy coat, and this was at a friendlier price point that just draped really well. I still think about that Loewe coat, but yeah, it's not happening anytime soon. I got this, and it's a great navy coat to wear. I wore this in Paris, and it's really easy to style. I can wear it with a hoodie. And I just really love coats that I can wear more dressed up and a little bit casually as well. Okay, now we're gonna get into some of my bigger and more oversized coats that I love to wear with hoodies and sweatshirts. The previous coats were more so on the dressier side. I tend to wear it with like not as chunky sweaters. I tend to wear them with thinner pieces. But for these coats, because of the size of them, I am able to wear a hoodie underneath and just get that kind of sporty, chill, casual look that I love so much. And this is great when it does start to get really, really cold. I can really layer up in these. This one is from Aritzia. The next few ones are gonna be from Aritzia, so just keep that in mind. This one is in black and looks really great with hoodies and sweatshirts. Really easy and kind of more of a masculine fit, and I think it works really well with hoodies and sweatshirts. Next up is the slouch in the gray color, and this is really recent. This is from this year, and I had been looking for a darker gray coat to add to my coat collection. This fit is really nice, and I just love that the material of this makes it a little bit more structured. I've yet to wear this coat out, but I'm really excited to. These particular coats look great in matching sweatsuits as well, so that's probably what I'm gonna do when I take this coat out for its maiden voyage out in the world. The next one is this beautiful chocolate brown one. Again, the slouch, but because of the material of this, I think it has camel hair, so it's a little bit softer and drapier. The gray one had a little bit more structure to it because it is wool. This one is just a beautiful chocolate brown, probably would look better with a white sweatshirt, but I was just in this gray hoodie for part of the video. But this is just a beautiful kind of oversized coat as well. Next one is this boucle coat, also from Aritzia, and I get so many compliments when I wear this. I don't know why, but I really love the texture of it and I really love the fit. I think it definitely is one of the pieces that you don't really see too often. Like everyone has a camel coat, but whenever I wear this, I get so many compliments on it, and I think it is because of that material. And so that is it for these oversized Aritzia, like heavier coats. All right, this next one you guys know is my absolute favorite, and it is my Monsieur Gabriel coat that I got back in 2017. It is beautiful. I love this coat so much, and I'm so bummed that they no longer make ready to wear. It just drapes so beautifully. I've had this for so long. I really get excited every single time it starts to get colder and I can just whip this bad boy out. One of my best investments. And I just love it so much. I really wish I could find it in black because I feel like it is such a sleek and chic piece. It's stunning. I honestly love this coat so much. Next up is another Aritzia coat, again on the thinner side. This is just a casual piece. I got this earlier this year. Haven't gotten a chance to wear it out yet, but it is in that nice light oatmeal color. This one you guys know is my Isabel Marant Shacket. This I got just a few months ago, and it's a great transitional piece, but I threw it in here because it is actually quite warm. So if I wanted to layer underneath this, I could get away with wearing this on a cooler day. It's a very cool, chill, and casual piece that I love to wear with like combat boots or sneakers. It's really just a great piece to throw on, especially if I'm running a quick errand, and I love that plaid print. This one is one of my more extra pieces, and this is from the Couples. I got this on sale last year, so this was not a full price piece. This is also not real fur, so just want to put that out there. It's faux fur, and it's just so soft and extra, and I love it. I'm not gonna be wearing it too much, but I think for the city, it is just such a cool piece, especially with like leather pants and just chunky boots. It's so soft, and it's just a really cool piece to have. I feel like I do think the Kooples has something similar this season, so maybe wait around for it to hit a Black Friday sale and you could get it for a good price. I think I got this for like one something, and they're originally maybe over 500. Don't quote me on that. Next up is my corduroy super puff that you guys know I got this year. I think it's just such a cute and casual piece that keeps it a little bit sporty, but isn't like the standard puffer. I really love this corduroy material. Feels a little bit retro to me, and I just love the color as well. I'm honestly not big on hoods because I love beanies as well, which might as well be another video of its own. But yeah, I love pairing beanies with my long and oversized coats. So yeah, this is my little shorty super puff, and it's really cute, and I look like a marshmallow in it. This is more of a spring coat, but I do wear it in the winter because I am able to layer underneath it. It's just a beautiful, nice, white, elegant piece. Does freak me out to have a white coat, but I don't take this out too often. I think I did bring it to Paris in 2018. It's really pretty and light and easy to wear. This is in like two sizes bigger than what I normally get because I found it on sale at Aritzia. So it's another really nice piece, and I feel like it's just very, very chic. I think I need to wear this with like an all white outfit. I feel like that would be a look. Okay, now we're up to the last piece, and this one is my go-to when it is freezing. New York weather can really dip, so when it is brick outside, this is my go-to coat if I really need to bundle up. I am in love with this duvet coat from Aritzia. It's like I'm staying in a comforter, I'm in bed, I'm in a sleeping bag. It's so comfortable, and I just love that it doesn't make me look so oversized, you know? There's still these clean lines to it, and it's really sleek, and I feel like it's still pretty slimming, which is hard for a maxi length puffer. I really love this one, and I love the pillowy collars. Again, really cute look with a hoodie, beanie. So yeah, that is pretty much it for my coat collection. If you are interested in any of the pieces, I will have the names down below and links if I can find them. I'll try and link similar pieces, but because these are similar styles and I can't really vouch for them in person, that is just something to keep in mind. So please read through the materials and the fabrics as well to see if it will work for you. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. And as always, your love and support mean the world to me, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.